This video goes with Section 20 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the present indicative active of thematic verbs that end in omega. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn on pages 45 and 46 for their coverage of the material, and they go back to it in the appendix on page 652. The present indicative active is present time and simple or continuous aspect, and to form it, we need principal part 1, and endings. So let's start with luo's first principal part and get the stem by taking off the omega. Now we need the endings and a chart to put them in, singular and plural, first, second, and third person. And here are the endings. O, eis, a, omen, ete, usi. The third plural can also have a new on the end. We call that a new movable. New movables work the way that our indefinite article works. Before a word that starts with a consonant, we say a or n, like a sofa or a sofa. But if a word starts with a vowel sound and we put the indefinite article in front of it, we say an armchair. We add an N movable. It works the same way with a new movable. If the next word starts with a vowel sound, you add the new movable to help with pronunciation. Greek also likes to have them before a pause, like a comma or at the end of a sentence. Present indicative active, like most verb forms, has recessive accent. The default translation for the present indicative active is she verbs for present time and simple aspect. Or she is verbing if you want to stress the continuous aspect of the present tense. So let's put this together. Principal part 1, endings and recessive accent. A chart to put them in. We start with principal part 1. Here we have the persons and numbers filled in with the first principal part stem of luo. And now we need the endings. So let's add them. O, eis, a, amen, ete, usi, or usen. Now we need to put in recessive accent. Remember your rules for accent and look at the last syllable. In the first person singular, it's long. And so we count one, two, and we put in an acute over the second to last syllable. In the second person singular, luis, we see long last syllable. So we count one, two, and we put in an acute over the second to last. In the third person singular, we see lue, so it's a long last syllable, and we count one, two, and put in an acute. In the plural, we see that the last syllable with that epsilon is short, so we count one, two, three, and we put in an acute over the third to last. Again, with luete, the last is short, and so we go one, two, three, and put in the acute over the third to last. And finally, with the third person plural, that iota at the end is short, so we count one, two, three, and we put in an acute over the last syllable. That's the whole conjugation. Luo, I free. Lues, you free. Lue, she frees, or he frees, or it frees. Luomen, we free. Luete, y'all free. And luusi, they free. Let's try another verb. Here's paideuo, educate, and its six principal parts. We go to the first, and take off the omega to get our stem. we add the ending and the recessive accent. So we get paideuo, I educate. In the second person singular, stem, ending, acute. Paideuos, you educate. Third person singular, paideuo, she educates, he educates, it educates. First person plural, stem, ending, accent. Paideuomen, we educate. Paideuete, second person plural, y'all educate. And third person plural, which could also have that new movable and then the accent, paideuousen, they educate. And there you have the present indicative active. You should be ready for drills, classwork, and translation.